Hello students, yesterday we have discussed about the importance of business environment. Now today we will continue with the chapter where we are going to talk about the effect of government policies. Government policies generally of our country which used to affect the business environment. The economic environment in India. Now when you talk about the economic environment of India, we talk about the stages of economic development of the country where the business enterprises gets a different type of economy. Where they can set up their stages, whether it's being a closed economy or whether it's being an open economy. So first we talk about that is the stage of economic development. When the enterprise is being set up, what type of economic system they are getting? Whether they are getting the closed economic system or whether they are getting the open economic system. Then we talk about economic structure. Now as we know, we have already studied in class 12 in the Indian economy, Indian economy, where we know that Indian economic system work under the mixed economic system, where the role of the public sector and the private sector works in the same way. Only what has been there, that is the distribution of the resources, is being defined by the public sector. So in this, in our economic structure, we can set up the industries, smaller industries in different parts of the country without being getting registered. So when we are talking about the MSME sectors, you might have heard about it in recently, that a lot of things are being done by the government. They are creating a lot of policies are being created by the government, whether we talk about the monetary policies and whether we talk about the fiscal policies for the upliftment of these smaller industrial units. Now, when we talk about industrial units, we know about the industrial policy in 1956. You're already studying in class 12, that where we talk about how to uplift the industries and how can we be self-reliant about ourselves. How can we be being self-reliant about ourselves and how can it be beneficial for the economic development of our country? So every year the economic policy, every time the government used to create the policies, they used to keep in the mind about the industrial sectors, the monetary policies and the fiscal policies, which always been beneficial for the development of the country. Then we talk about economic planning. Now we know there always being a five-year plans, which always being a perspective plans for the next 20 years. Then where do we see our economic structure? Where do we see our country after 20 years? So these 5-year plans are always being created and the annual budgets are being spent out in different parts of the units, in different parts of the sector. Whether we talk about the agriculture sector, whether we talk about the industrial sector, those economic structure which used to be beneficial to the economic policies, which are being beneficial for the development of the country, that economic planning is always being done. Then we talk about the economic indices. When we talk about the economic indices like national income, distribution of income, so these are the things, indices, which are the role in the economic policies of a country, where we include the rate and growth of GNP, GDP, per capita income, disposal personal income. When we talk about disposal personal income, that is the income which is being there in the hands of the people, which they are going to use for the, where they are going to use that particular income for the expenses in the market. That is then the rate of savings and investment, the value of exports and import, balance of payment and so on. So these are the economic indices which are being the part of the economic structure and which are going to affect the business environment. Then we talk about the infrastructural factors. Infrastructural factors are not being related to the roads and railways. Over here we are talking about the infrastructure factors, that is financial institutions, the banks, the modes of transportations, communication facilities and so on, which are being affecting the economic environment, where financial institutions are being providing up the loans to those particular industries so that they can be set up and can have a growth in the market. But at what rate of interest they are providing it, how much loan they are providing it, banks, how much loans are being providing up, transportation, how the things are can be carried down from one place to the another place. So these infrastructure factors which affect the businesses are being the part of economic environment in India. Now, economic policies before 1991. Now, before 1991, we were dependent upon the inward-looking trade policy. Now, inward-looking trade policy means that we were totally being dependent upon the public sectors. Public sector was being responsible for the development of our country. which has been totally very, if any other private sector want to set up the industries, they have to take a license from the government. So there was a lot of restrictions, regulations and control to set up an industry at that period of time. So at that period of time, the most of the responsibility, the most of the development part was there in the hands of the public sector, due to which the government has to suffer a lot of deficit. Deficit means the government has taken a lot of loan, and during during 1991, there was a lot of loan being taken by the government, which they are not able to repay. And government wants more loan. So at that time, and during that period of time, there was soaring inflation, and the foreign exchange was also being reduced. They have around 3 days foreign exchange left with them. So due to which, the government went asked for the more loan from the World Bank. The World Bank said, if you are not going to change the economic policies, we are not able to provide you the loan. So what they have done at that time, your finance minister at that period of time, the finance minister, Mr. Manmohan Singh, what he has done, he changed the economic policies of our country. What he has done, he has reduced the public sector industries. There he privatized most of the public sector industries into the private sectors, and he liberalized the economic policies, with the help of which a lot of foreign industries from the different part of the world came into our industry and they started up investing in our country. So he brought up a new policy with the name of LPG model, which is known as liberalization, privatization and globalization. So we are going to discuss about LPG model one by one, and what are the policies which are being there under liberalization, privatization and globalization. We are going to discuss that how these LPG model help in the development and changing the business environment and business policies in our country, which was helpful for the economic development of our country. Now, everyone knows what do you understand by liberalization. Now, liberalization means that as we are ending the role of the licensing RAS system, that we do not have to take the license for starting up any of the industries after 1991. So what we have done, we have abolished the licensing equipment in most of the industries except a short list. A short list means some of the industries are still requiring the licensing, for example, the chemical industries, while most rest of the industries are being freed out from the licensing system, that you do not have to take a license for starting up industries. So a lot of private sectors are being came at that period of time to start up an industry. So if you think about yourself, if you try to keep yourself at that time, if you are being a businessman, so if this system would have been finished off, it would have become easier for you to start up an industry. Because you do not have to take a license, a little bit of paperwork must be required, and very easily, you can start up an industry at that period of time. So abolishing the license system, permit quota RAS system, makes it easier for the people to start up an industry at that period of time. Then, now, you also have a freedom to decide at what scale, whether you want to start at a smaller scale, whether you want to start at a medium scale or larger scale. You do not have to take the permission at what scale you want to start up an industry. So those people who want to start up an industry at a larger scale, they do not have to think about it, because you were free for that starting up that particular business activity. Now, they have removed the restrictions on the movement of goods and services also, from one place to another, from one state to the another state, from one country to another country. It becomes easier for the people to set up the goods and services. Do not have to take the permission for about from anyone. So there was no restriction at that period of time, so that the people are able to send their goods from one place to another, because they have removed the restrictions from that particular movement. Now, there were also being for freedom that you do not have to ask from the government at what price I should sell the goods. Because before 1991, the most of the part was there in the hands of the public sector. So the public sector used to decide at what price I should be selling the goods. But after 1991, the freedom has been given to the private sector at what price they want to sell up their goods. So that freedom for fixing the prices of goods and services were in the hands of the private sector. They don't have to take the permission from the public sector. So at whatever price they want to sell, they can sell that particular good. There was no reduction. They have reduced the tax rates and lifting of unnecessary control over the economy. What did the government do? They removed a lot of tax rates. They have reduced the tax rates so that it becomes easier for the industries to be set up in that particular field. For example, if I'm going to start up an industry, in that particular industry, if the government says that no tax should be given on that particular industry, it becomes easier for me because whatever the profit will be earned will be in my hands. I don't have to give that particular tax on that particular business. In the same way, if any business I have from a person is being doing at that period of time, if the tax rates could have been reduced, the profit would have been increased. So, reduction in tax rate attracted a lot of businessmen at that period of time, and lifting of unnecessary controls over the economy becomes easier for the business. The liberalization has brought a lot of, it's been a revolution at that period of time, which brought a lot of industries to be set up in that particular period. So simplifying the procedures, what did the government has done? For importing and exporting, he has simplified the procedure. Before, the labor got up restrictions for the importing and exporting because the government was thinking about the self-reliability. But after 1991, they have simplified the procedures for import and export by reducing the tax, by reducing the paperwork between the two countries. So it makes easier for the people to import and export the goods. Because of making the things easier, it makes easier for the foreign investors to invest in our country and also for the Indian companies to get the foreign technologies which they are using, their technologies can be used by our own businessmen, so that they are able to compete with those foreign industries which are being set up in different parts of the world. And that because of the liberalization, most of the foreign industries are being set up in our industry, in our country, to which it becomes, it brings more revolution in the market. So that is the meaning of liberalization. Liberalization means removing the restrictions and allowing the companies to be the part of the private sectors. Now, next is privatization. Now, what do you understand by privatization? Now, what did public sector government did? They have reduced a lot of public sector industries into a private sector industries. So, what is that? The public sector, the role of the public sector in economic activities have been reduced. Why? By reducing the public sector industries to a private sector industries. So, what did they do? They disinvested the public sector among the private sector, so that there can be upliftment and lot of competition can be there in the market, which would be beneficial for the economic development of our country. So what they have done, they set up a BIFR, that is the Board of Industrial and Reconstruction. Now we have studied about this in class 11, that BIFR, what is the function of BIFR? Now I can explain to you, that BIFR used to see, goes to each and every public sector industries, and they used to see whether these industries, if I am going to invest in that particular industry, whether they are going to, will they be beneficial for the upliftment, will they function in a better mode or not. Matlab BIFR ka function ye tha ki ye chahte the sare public industries ko unko check out karte the ki ispe agar hum invest karenge to companies ko fayda hoga ki nahi, वो प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी मोड में फिर से आ पाएगी नहीं, और अगर इन्वेस्ट करने से नहीं आती है तो क्या करते थे, उन इंडस्ट्रीज को बंद करके बेच देते थे टू द प्राइवेट सेक्टर, और जो पैसा उससे आता था उस इंडस्ट्री में इन्वेस्ट करते थे जिसमें वो इन्वेस्टमेंट करके वो फायदा कर से री स्टार्ट कर सकते थे और उनको प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी मोड में ला सकते थे. तो दैट वॉज अ फंक्शन ऑफ बीआरएफआर. तो उन्होंने तब एट दैट टाइम गवर्नमेंट ने क्या किया, तो जो लॉस मेकिंग यूनिट्स थे उनको बीआरएफआर के थ्रू चेक कराया गया कि उनमें अगर इन्वेस्टमेंट किया जाए तो प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी मोड में आ सकते कि नहीं. अगर वो प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी मोड में नहीं आएंगे तो उनको हम सेल आउट कर देंगे, और जो उनसे पैसा जनरेट होगा उन कंपनीज में इन्वेस्ट करेंगे जहां से वो प्रॉफिट जनरेट कर. तो दैट वाज़ द फंक्शन ऑफ प्राइवेटाइजेशन. नेक्स्ट वी हैव ग्लोबलाइजेशन. नाउ व्हेन वी टॉक अबाउट ग्लोबलाइजेशन, इट मीन्स इंटीग्रेटिंग द वर्ल्ड इकोनॉमी. Integrating the world economy means that is any country can invest in our country, and our country businessmen can invest in the other country. So what we can do, what it means, that is the world economy becomes a global part of a country. where we can invest in other part of the countries, we can provide the goods and services to other part of the country, and the other part of the country can provide us the goods and services in our part of the country. So that becomes, that increase at that period of time. So the economic interdependence, we started to become economically interdependent each other, where if a company from the US want to start up our own business in our country, they can decide about the prices by themselves. The government is not going to interfere in their business and deciding about the prices. So what we have done, what our government have done, they have abolished the import license, where importing of goods becomes easier for the businessmen who are being the part of our country and who are being the part of our country to get the goods from the other country. So they have abolished the import license. Due to which the government has removed the restriction, tariff restrictions and quantitative restriction, which makes the business for the foreign countries, easier in our country. So a lot of multinational companies are being set up after 1991. So due to which our economy becomes more stronger, and we started getting a lot of foreign exchange reserves, due to which our economy becomes stronger and stronger day by day. So globalization se kya hua, humne kya kiya, humne apni economy ko world economy mein transform kar diya. Jahan pe koi bhi desh hamare economy mein invest kar sakta tha, aur hum kisi bhi desh mein jaake unki economy mein invest kar sakte. Jisse kya hua, bahut sare goods and services humne kya kiye, exchange kiye, aur गवर्नमेंट ने क्या किया, गवर्नमेंट ने हमारी इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज में इंटरफेयर, जो भी फॉरेन कंपनी सेटअप हुई उनकी इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज में कोई इंटरफेयर नहीं किया. वो चाहे तो अपने हिसाब से प्राइसेस डिसाइड कर सकते थे और वो कुछ सेल कर सकते थे. और हमारी गवर्नमेंट ने क्या किया कि इम्पोर्ट लाइसेंस को ही पूरी तरीके से खत्म कर दिया, ताकि क्या हुआ, हम अब दूसरे देश की टेक्नोलॉजीज को, दूसरे देश की सर्विसेज को इजिली हम अडॉप्ट कर पाए. Due to globalization, we become the part of the global world, and we are able to have an economical structure where we can compete with the global world. Now, what is the impact of LPG, that is liberalization, privatization, globalization model? Now, uska impact kya pada business pe hamare country mein? Pehla impact hua ki competition badh gaya. कंपटीशन बढ़ गया. क्यों बढ़ गया? बहुत सारे प्राइवेट सेक्टर्स जब मार्केट में आए तो वो लोग क्या करने लगे, आपस में कॉम्पीट करने लगे, जिसका फायदा हमारी इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट पे हुआ. सो व्हाट हैपेंस, अ लॉट ऑफ, व्हेन अ लॉट ऑफ बिजनेस, व्हेन वी लिबरलाइज अप द पार्टनर बिजनेसेस, व्हेन वी प्राइवेटाइज द बिजनेसेस, अ लॉट ऑफ बिजनेसमैन केम इन द मार्केट, ड्यू टू व्हिच अ कॉम्पिटिशन इंक्रीज अमंग द मार्केट, व्हिच बेनिफिटेड द कस्टमर्स, व्हिच बेनिफिटेड द इकोनॉमिक डेवलपमेंट ऑफ आवर कंट्री. सेकंड, we have more demanding customers. Pehle kya hota tha, before 1991, whatever the goods are being produced by the government, you have to purchase it. You do not have any choices. But after 1991, when a lot of private sector came into that market, we have more demanding customers. Customers demands badh gaye, kyunki unke paas bahut sara choices hone lagi. So whatever the goods are being created by the businessmen are being dependent upon the customers' needs rather being on the business oriented projects. Then rapidly changing technological environment. Now private sector होने से क्या हुआ, privatization होने से technological environment बहुत सारे changes हुआ. Because of the abolition of the import duties, which we have already studied in the previous part, you might have seen कि import duty खत्म होने से बहुत सारी technologies जो दूसरे देशों में adopt होती थी वो हमारे देशों में भी adopt होने लगी. वो सारे चेंजेस हमारे देश में भी होने लगे जो दूसरे देशों में होते थे. टेक्नोलॉजिकल एनवायरनमेंट चेंज होने लगा, वेयर वी कैन गेट मोर एंड बेटर एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इन द मार्केट, विच कैन हैव द पॉजिटिव इफेक्ट फॉर द बिजनेसमैन एंड कैन हैव द नेगेटिव इफेक्ट फॉर द अदर बिजनेसमैन. सो ड्यू टू द इंक्रीज इन द कॉम्पिटिशन ऑल्सो देयर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ चेंज इन द टेक्नोलॉजिकल एवरी डे, एंड राइट नाउ ऑल्सो वी कैन सी अ लॉट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजिकल चेंज इज बीइंग ब्रॉट अप इन द मार्केट. देन necessity for change. Now, necessity for change, you have to bring up the changes in the market. Why it has been required? Because of the change in the technology, the change in the environment, the change in the need of the customers. The main reason is only because in the previous years before 1991, whatever the goods are being produced, were goods are being produced by the public sector. Now, whatever the goods now is being produced, are being produced according to the needs and the requirement of the customers. That's why we have to change the necessity. Okay? Then need for developing human resources. Human resources, why it is being required? Because we have been competing in the global world. So it is being required that the human resources should be in such a manner that their thinking, their mentality should be according to the mentality of the global world. What other countries people are thinking and how globally the market has been covering up. Human resources, the requirement of the human resources have been increased. And whatever the products are being created on the basis of market orientation rather than on the basis of business orientation. So where we are talking about the goods are being produced according to the needs and according to the requirement of the customers. So with this chapter, we are able to understand that the environment, the specific factors and the general factors are the most important factors of our business. They have to be in touch with those particular factors to be the part of the business environment. If they want to be the part, they want to compete in the global world. You have to be in touch with those specific and general factors so that it can be beneficial for the business, for their upliftment and to be the part of the global world. Hope you have understood the whole complete chapters. Those who are not able to understand, you can contact me whenever you want. And try to see all the 4 videos of this particular chapter to understand the chapter in a much better way. Thank you.